Excel's Goal Seek feature allows you to start off with the result you want, then Excel will work backward, mathematically, to find the missing variable to get you there. Or you can change a variable used in a formula to see how it affects the outcome of that formula. We find Goal Seek in the What If Analysis dropdown from the Data tab. In a simple example, maybe you're in school and you want to know what grade you need to get on your biology exam in order to have at least a 75% average overall. When we click on this dropdown and select Goal Seek, we want to set cell B7 to 75%. By changing the value in cell B6. We hit OK, and Excel is looking for what value we need to get an average of 75%. So Excel here works backwards and tells us that we need to score 95% to bring our average up to 75%. We hit OK to accept, and the value of 95% is entered in cell B6. So now, maybe you're ready for a slightly more challenging example. Here's one that we might come across, taking a loan from a bank. Let's say that you want to borrow $12,000 from the bank. You already know the bank's interest rate and the number of months you'll take to repay the loan. In this situation, the PMT function has been applied to calculate the monthly payment amount. But maybe we've decided that this won't work for us because the monthly payments are too high. Maybe we can pay $300, but not $370. So we may decide to take out a smaller loan. Let's do a Goal Seek to find out how much we'd qualify for. So in our Goal Seek window, there are a couple of things to bear in mind. First, the cell we choose in the Set Cell field must be a cell containing a formula. And B6 does contain our PMT formula, so that works. We want it to be a value of $300, but this is a payment amount, so it's going to be minus 300. The cell chosen in the By Changing Cell field must be a cell containing a constant that's related to the Set Cell field. So we want to change cell B1, and this constant was used in the PMT function. And third, we want to remember that the Goal Seek feature only allows the adjustment of a single variable at a time. We hit OK, and Excel calculates that regular payments of $300 will only qualify us for a loan of $9,600. The last thing to remember is that once we select OK from the Goal Seek status window, the values on the worksheet are adjusted, and they're only reversible by selecting the Undo command. We do want to accept this amount. We hit OK, and the loan amount has been changed. One of the complaints with Goal Seek is that sometimes the solutions aren't precise enough. In this example, we want this value, we'll call it x, raised to the power of 2. What value will give us the number 6 as the result? Let's enter the values in Goal Seek. So we want to set cell B2 to a value of 6 by changing cell A2. We hit OK and Excel is calculating. We see that the answer is close, but it's not quite what we're looking for. The difference between our desired outcome and the calculated value might not seem that great, but if X really represented millions of dollars or was a quality measurement that needed absolute precision, we would need to get an answer that's closer to our goal. There are two settings in Excel which provide a more precise solution when using Goal Seek. Let's find out how to do that. We'll click Cancel here because we don't want to accept this result. We need to go to File and Options. Then we go to the Formulas options. And we notice this section, Maximum Iterations and Maximum Change. Maximum iterations means the number of attempts Excel can make to arrive at a solution, and maximum change means the degree of accuracy required of Excel's solution. The default number of iterations is 100, and if we want Excel to attempt more possible solutions, we can increase the maximum number of iterations. The default maximum change is 0.001, so the Goal Seek will be accurate to this fraction. But if we want to force Excel to find a more precise solution, we can adjust the maximum change to a really small number. So let's put in some extra zeros. So if these figures that we were working with was really millions of dollars, then putting 5 zeros is making the difference between our goal and the solution not more than $1, if these figures really represent millions of dollars. So let's hit OK, and we'll rerun our goal seek. We want to set cell B2 to a value of 6 by changing cell A2, and let's look for a solution. And now Excel returns a more precise solution, and we accept. As mentioned before, GoalSeek works with only one variable input at a time. There are other what-if analysis tools in Excel like Scenario Manager, Data Tables, and Solver, which have even more robust capabilities. Check out our other resources to learn more about these functionalities in Excel.
Ready to learn more about Microsoft Excel? Then check out the full course on GoSkills.com. Click the link in the description.